In his first address to the 11th Parliament on Monday, President Yoweri Museveni recounted the behind-the-scenes events ahead of the election of the Speaker of Parliament, even after the NRM Central Executive Committee selected Jacob Olanya and Rebecca Kadaga put up a spirited fight to retain their speakership.
I was reading some people at 11:30, 12 in the night. So now you have been with Kadaga, the official candidate now is Olanya.
Museveni kept his eyes glued on the dice, sitting through the voting process for both the Speaker and Deputy Speaker at the Kololo Independence Grounds.
His presence there, he was displaying a power that he has the ability to influence people to do what they may not wish to do.
Nkakuba says this was a replica of the 2016 speakership race, and which is evidence of Museveni showing he is in full control.
He had to work so hard to ensure that the candidate goes through, because it would be a big blow if in his presence his members would act against his wish or the wish of the party.
However, Bayendeza, a lecturer at Tim University, says recognition of Kadaga's ambitions and paving way for her deputy to become speaker was masterminded by the NRM SEC, which compelled the party caucus to endorse the very position.
President, who is the head of the executive, must ensure that these other two arms, the legislature and the judiciary, are heavily controlled by the executive. So he has to ensure that his team is in those two offices. And of recent, Kadaga had tried to show signs of disobedience. Even she had started showing signs, some desires and interests for the high office, which is a big threat to the executive.
He says that voting was by secret ballot, which could have afforded the members the opportunity to vote their own choice, but instead, many towed the line of the party's top organ. Bayendeza says the MPs were conflicted by the calls from Museveni and the fear of being vilified.
There was a group that was pro-Kadaga, Kadaga diehards. And of course there is a number which was estimated to vote for Kadaga. So they didn't bother themselves with that. So if the number went beyond the Kadaga diehards, then it would be clear that people have betrayed the cause. So they had to be very careful. Remember that this is a system. You can betray it, but the repercussions come to you even tomorrow.
The experts say the ramification of having a Speaker of Parliament and Chief Justice placed in these positions by the head of state are that service delivery is crippled, given the reduced ability to question the executive.